Dear visitors, dear guests in our capital, Ljubljana, in Slovenia, dobro došli. Welcome. Welcome again in our studio, Ljubljana for you. We local tourist guides, we always like to do our best that all the visitors would feel Ljubljana as we do. So that means that all a lot of this positive energy that we feel towards the capital, also the visitors would do. There are quite a few different visitors, most probably you noticed. There are a lot of businessmen living in Ljubljana, temporarily, mainly for a few months. A lot of exchange students, a lot of travelers, maybe staying here for a day or two. And there are also some exceptions, like our tonight's visitor, and this is Terry Anzur. Dobar dan, Terry.
Dobar dan. And I'm very happy to be here. Thanks for having me.
That was really nice. Dobar dan. Kako ste, Terry?
Zelo dobro.
You see, some of the visitors put extra effort and they even learn Slovenian. However, there is a trick. Terry is a very nice combination of American and Slovenian name. You write your name Terry, which is very American, and then is a little trick with your family name, Anzur. That's very Slovenian.
Yes, my grandparents came from Slovenia in 1911. And my father was born in the United States.
All right.
And more recently, myself and my son have become citizens of Slovenia through ancestry. So we came here in 2009 to begin to look for our family's history. And there are many, many people in the United States who are Slovene Americans, and they also have this history. And one of the purposes of my blog is to let people know that this history is here, and they really must come to Slovenia to discover it.
So first of all, I think we should all congratulate to Terry and her son that they chose a Slovenian citizenship, because I think that's quite an honor also for us that were born in Slovenia, that somebody from the United States worked hard to get a Slovenian citizenship. What does it mean to you?
It means that I'm connected to my roots. And everywhere I go in Slovenia, it feels to me like home. I recognize things from my childhood, like potica, goveja juha, how people love sports and love to be outside, because this is how I was raised.
So your father, or let's say also grandparents, but you never met your grandparents, or?
No, they were dead by the time I was born.
But that was passed to your father, so let's say traditional way of living from Slovenia was passed from your grandparents to your father, and then from your father to you.
And my father was never allowed to learn Slovene language because his parents wanted him to be American and speak only English. So now my son and I are trying to learn this Slovene language. Govorim malo slovensko, zelo malo.
Odlična, ampak odlična. You are doing really excellent.
Najlepša hvala.
Yeah.
But it's very difficult for me. Yeah. For my son, it's easier because from my mother's side, he already speaks Polish.
All right. Yeah, that's a Slavic language, so it's a bit easier for him. Yeah. And you said that you already know goveja juha and potica. So you cooked at home Slovenian food?
We cooked it, but we had no idea it was Slovenian food.
Right.
I was always told as a child I was from Austria.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And then one time I was working as a journalist and the ambassador of Austria asked me where was my family from, and I said, oh, near Ljubljana. And they said, oh, no, you're Slovenian.
Bravo.
That was a big day for me.
Good ambassador of Austria.
Yes, and lucky day for me.
Yeah.
Because when I went to Austria, it didn't feel quite right, but this is home.
Yeah. Actually, we were a part of Austria in those days, Austro-Hungarian monarchy, 1918. Of course, in every passport, then it was written like Austrian citizen. So, Terry, you said that you came here in 2009. So it's almost 10 years ago. You were already a blogger at that time, or you became later on?
Well, just to give a little background, I was a television journalist in the United States for about 25 years in all the big cities, New York, Los Angeles, Chicago, Texas, Florida, also on a national program about politics. And then I was a professor at the University of Southern California teaching journalism before I started my own company where I train journalists all over the world. And so I've been to some interesting countries like Pakistan and Ethiopia. And so I get a chance to write about these places and I started the blog. But now, because of my love for Slovenia, I'm going to specialize in Slovenia and I hope to become an expert on the destination like you are.
And you are going to be a real ambassador of Slovenia because nowadays there are more and more Americans coming to our region. I mean, I won't say only to Slovenia, but generally to Croatia, Italy, Austria. Tell me, what are they attracted to here in Slovenia? What is the topic that it's more let's say mostly attractive to them, that it's worth spending their money? Because we know that Americans are hardworking. They don't have so many days off as we have here in Slovenia. So their time is very precious.
Well, one thing is just getting Americans to realize where Slovenia is on the map. Sometimes, as you know, they confuse it with Slovakia.
Right.
And so the election of Donald Trump with the First Lady Melania Trump has done a lot to put Slovenia on the map for Americans who may never have heard of it before.
Sure.
So now they're wondering, what is Slovenia, if they already don't have the heritage from here? And they know Ljubljana is a great city, and Bled is world famous. And maybe they will come here and also visit Postojna Cave, which is also very popular. But the purpose of my blog is to convince Americans to spend more time. Because we love the adventure. We love the nature. We also love the great wine and food. And we have Vipava Valley and Gorska Brda, which are great for foodies and wine lovers. So what I say is take a week, take even 2 weeks, go to Piran, go to Maribor, go to Selje, so many other things, so many mountains, adventures. Try the wine, try the food. And I think it's a trip that people will always remember.
So your goal public or audience is actually who? Do you have a goal public?
My target audience is adults who are over 50, most of them. But they have adult children. And so they're looking for something that would be interesting to more than one generation. And they're very active. They have time and money to travel. And I think they're very pleasantly surprised that Slovenia is quite affordable. It's much lower priced than some other destinations, like, say, in France or maybe Germany.
Or maybe even Italy or Austria and our neighbors.
So their dollars and their euros go much farther here. And then just the variety of the experiences that are available, everything from art and high culture to great adventures out in the wild.
And you also mentioned the food, because, you know, in every part of Slovenia, you have actually different kind of food, different kind of wines. You mentioned Goriška Brda, Vipava Valley. There is still the coast. There is still
Styria. I know. I don't want to leave anybody out. There's about seven wine growing regions, and I intend to drink wine in all of them, so don't worry. And I made a great wine tasting tour of all of these regions just here in Ljubljana.
Well, actually, we also noticed that the food and the wine is something that is the most pleasant way to present the cultural heritage. Because, you know, once you sit at the table, we start to talk about many different kind of topics. And then a lot of topics from the past arise. And of course, then we have today's situation in the city. So, yeah, I would definitely recommend one of these tours, as you said, food tours or wine tours. And how do you think what we should do to actually really persuade Americans to stay longer, not just 2 days?
I think you have to give them a plan. If they're interested in adventure, you make it easy for them to go to the Socha River and do some kayaking.
So concrete suggestions.
Yes, yes. Because we have, you know, the Grand Canyon, we have the Rockies.
True.
So only saying, oh, we have mountains and we have rivers. But
that's
to really
enough,
say you've never seen water this color, to really say you've never seen a lake with a historic church in the middle of it.
To know
that in Piran you have a little piece of Venice, but without the tourist crowds, you have the place to yourself practically. There's just so much here if you give them a plan and a story.
And a story.
Because we have so much nature and in the United States, we're lacking in the history.
We
have history, but it doesn't go back as far as it does here in Europe.
Yeah, I think that storytelling now is like the top topic, what we should include in our presentation, interpretation. However, sometimes I notice that when I bring people to a regular family or ordinary family that runs normal life, that's already a nice story for them. Because it's different than the story of the life in the United States.
And it's so interesting to people of my generation, the 50 plus, because we remember a time when it was Yugoslavia.
Yes.
And maybe a little bit forbidden in a way, and a little bit secret. And so now to see how the country is coming into a whole new period of history is really exciting. It's a very exciting time to be here. And a big plus for Americans, since many Americans don't speak any other languages, is that so many people, particularly in Ljubljana and throughout Slovenia, are speaking English. And I think when they know that, they won't be so afraid to plan and spend more time.
Well, that's what I usually notice. You know, we bring people maybe from neighboring countries for a day to Ljubljana or to neighboring places, and they say, oh, it's so safe here. Everybody speaks English. The roads are nice. So they feel more comfortable.
Yes, it's easy to drive in this country. If you rent a car, the roads are very well marked. And Americans, I think, once they come here and they see how really easy it is to get around, or if you book a tour, you know, then that's really relaxing on your holidays, because then all of the directions and everything are taken care of by a professional like you.
Well, we try to do that, but sometimes we would like them maybe just to spend a little time with us. I mean, they don't need to spend 3 days with us, you know, but just maybe for the start, for an introduction, to feel more comfortable, and then they can explore on their own, because I think they like a kind of a freedom that they do it their way. What do you think?
I think everybody is different. I recently spoke with a traveler who wanted to not think about anything, wanted everything to be planned and easy for her. Other people like the adventure of wandering off the beaten path. And the thing about Slovenia is you can do it all. And, and in the world now where it's so dangerous in some countries, and even in countries that, you know, we always thought were pretty safe. Now, maybe not so much. So just to have this opportunity in Slovenia to experience another country, another culture that is totally new is very exciting.
Actually, the title of your blog is Strangers in the Living Room. How come?
Well, because whenever you travel, you are a stranger in somebody's living room.
Ah.
And today we spoke of Prešeren Square being the living room of Ljubljana, where tourists very often start their visit and meet their guide. So it's perfect. But our famous playwright Tennessee Williams wrote a line in one of his plays: whoever you are, I've always depended on the kindness of strangers. And when you have a good trip somewhere, it's usually because a stranger has helped you out along the way. And in my blog, I try to introduce people who will welcome strangers into their living room.
Actually, this is the main role of a tourist guide, that what you've done just now, that we all become friends. But on the other hand, I think that the advantage of Slovenia is that also ordinary people become your friends. when you go to a grocery store or to the market, you said that, let's say that we speak quite well English. You don't need to speak a lot in order to feel welcome and comfortable. Do you think that when a visitor goes to the market, feels welcome?
Well, it's a little bit intimidating because, especially if you kind of maybe look a little bit European,
yes,
they will, of course, speak Slovene to you. And
yes,
if you haven't taken the time to learn, you know, vala, prosim,
yes,
gotovina, ali kartica,
uh-huh,
you know, it's intimidating. But quickly, if you look confused, they'll go right to English,
English,
if they can. And I just want to share one funny story. I took a really nice tour of Maribor,
yes,
and the guide became my friend on Facebook,
mm-hmm,
and now we Facebook all the time.
Yes.
So when you encounter these people who are the helpful strangers,
yes,
along the way,
yeah,
these are the experiences that will make your trip to Slovenia extra special.
Okay, thank you very much, Terry. I think that you made the whole destination more close to your visitors, or let's say to your citizens from United States, and that they won't feel afraid anymore coming to our area, and that they will feel also friends among us and not just strangers. Thank you very much, and wish you all the best.
Thank you.
На свидание.